I have some pictures to you, because as you just heard from Juha, the one thing you human beings are still better than AI is interpreting pictures. So we try to get them visible as well. So I just like to share a bit of reflections. I've been living through two waves of digitalization. I saw the internet age and the dot-com boom, and then I saw the IoT coming and the industrial internet when I was working for Kone, and now I do believe that this AI will be our next big wave of digitalization, or maybe Risto Siilasmaa is right, and that it's a megatrend of its own, even bigger thing than the digitalization. We shall see. But I think we can learn something from these previous waves, and just my reflections. What are the typical discussions what we need to go through? Firstly, of course, you need to start from your business model. As Juha is saying, that what is the true impact of this transformation to our business? And it's not always so easy to see. Is this just incremental improvement for efficiency, or is this a true transformation, or is this a change in the customer behavior? And I think people are quite puzzled, typically trying to understand that what does it mean for our business? And the same reflection, it's a lot of hype. You know, everybody should be in this beautiful ecosystem and everything will change and so forth and so forth. And at least kind of my reality, what I see in the industrial companies, that the reality is still very much this. This is how the typical industrial company still thinks. This is their ecosystem. And I have some old colleagues here, and we became really masters in making this supply chain like the hugely effective. And that's how we see the world. And it's really difficult to see how to start from optimizing that to the perfection to this mysterious world of ecosystems. And what I found very useful when working in the industrial companies, that everybody should become, firstly, it's a baby step, but it's a good step, to become a software company. So I think every single industrial company should become a software company and start adopting those good principles that are already there in software engineering and in software companies. It's very natural for a software company to think about the ecosystem. None of our applications work without other applications. So you always know your position in that ecosystem. You manage your development cycles, you produce those services to your customers, and use all these good tools. And we just need to now teach all the industrial companies to start behaving like this, becoming a software company, because that will bring already the capabilities of data and analytics and customer service thinking to the table. Then another kind of, be careful. Another difficult discussion is about the technology. And I've been a CIO for at least 7 years now, and don't come to tell me that technology is cheap and available and easy to apply. It's not. It's not. It has proven to be very difficult. And again, these hype pictures are so annoying. You just take our AI solution and miracles will happen and all your things become connected and ta-da, you have the answer. And by the way, it used to be cloud just a few years ago in this picture, so you can actually copy-paste all the kind of Google search pictures and put, you know, your AI and replace with the cloud. And this is what I've been, at least all the dear suppliers have been selling me, this dreamland, whereas as a CIO, my reality is like this. And it doesn't change. I mean, it's been the same in all the companies I've been working with and even with the university. This is the kind of typical world of legacy systems we are living in. Hundreds, if not thousands, of old applications with all kinds of old integrations. And then you have this screenshot coming from the 80s with giving messages of bad quality data. And this is the real life for any CIO in this country, at least I know. And it's a massive step you need to make in order to start utilizing those technologies. So what I think is kind of one, again, baby step we need to take, and this was very useful, for example, when we were building the digitalization strategy for Kone, to start understanding that we need to understand the whole concept of product and technology differently. So this is the new product. You take your physical components, then you need to start managing them as a separate platform. You take your smart components, you need to manage your connectivity cloud, your data and analytics, your processes, applications, user experience, ecosystem. And this is the new product. And it's quite an interesting discussion, for example, in an elevator company, that, by the way, the elevators are just here. And now we start managing everything on top of that. And you need to have the best of engineers managing all these different layers. And then you need to manage the operations and the security and all that. And credits to Professor Martti Mäntylä, who taught me this concept. And this is like a blonde version of it, but it works. And this is right, really how to change the mindset, how to start applying the technologies. And there is no difference between IT and other technologies in this picture. And this could help industrial companies to go forward. Then we have the third big dilemma. I call it the CXO dilemma. It's always about the organization, that who is going to do this and how to change the organization. And again, there is a lot of hype. You know, we are all here with the, we are collaborating and networking and we have a lot of good energy here. We know we need to deal with startups and have all kinds of interesting things happening. But when we go back to the office, we live with this. And again, I would say that the kind of 95% of Finnish industrial companies are still in this mode. Hugely functional, hugely siloed organizations running today's business. How do you start implementing that technology change? Because the responsibilities are unclear. What does R&D do, IT do, so forth? How do you put any customer centricity in this picture when you're running your daily functional business? And again, this is true to any organization as we go. So one of our key challenges, again, is this between hype and this reality of the current organizations, and what do we do? And I don't have a simple answer, but I do think we need to get from these functions to true digital collaboration. And you need to change the organization. I'm at least a bit frustrated that people set up all kinds of separate digital business units somewhere, and then they think that it will change the world. It will not. You need to tackle the fundamentals of the existing organization in order to get it going. And again, same reflection, sorry about the Finnish text, but again, one of those banks in Finland saying what they are doing right now, firing 260 and hiring 160. And we need to get used to this news. And it applies to any organization that tries to apply truly these technologies. And we cannot avoid it just by setting up a simple, nice pilot unit somewhere. It's a starting point, but it will not change the game. And if the organization is not ready for this discussion, we will miss the game overall. So I think these kind of three fundamental questions remain also for AI age. The business model, how do we do it? Then the kind of how to build the real technology stack and what are the different technology layers we are doing? And then this fundamental question on how to organize and are we ready to take the organizational change? But will there be something different then in this AI wave? I don't know, but at least I know it's about talent. So we tend to say that data is the new oil, but I think the digital talent is the new oil. Because the data will be available, I actually think it will be available. So AI will make these integrations and data availability and quality better, but then it's a question of the talent. And who can find the talent and keep them motivated and keep on developing all these challenges we are facing and utilizing the data. And then it's interesting again to come back to this, is this a true disruption? And I took one from my own world today. This is from the university world, really exciting case. Small news 1 year ago that there is a very prestigious university, University of Tokyo. So they made an AI system combined with the robot arm. And it was the first time it passed the university entrance exam, which is like one of the most difficult ones in the whole world, made by hand, all kinds of literacy, mathematics, physics, history, etc. So it's now better than a kind of average student that enters the university. And I'm having interesting discussions with AI professors here at Aalto. What shall we do then? Should we accept this guy to study? Are we going to teach the human beings? Or these creatures? And what do we teach to these human beings? And they are actually giving me very clever answers that Kati, now it's time to talk about the human identity more than ever. That all we need to teach to our students is the human identity, who they are, and what they need to know, and how to live as human beings in order to make those good questions that AI will help us to answer. Thank you.